you know, again, I come back to this panel is on values, because without values, and a clear sense of values, not even education is a panacea. And I'm wondering, you know, what is happening to values in education? Kurt Vonnegut was a couple of, I think, yeah, last year, went to give a lecture at MIT, and he discovered some very interesting thing about the changing values of very, very best and brightest students to go to a place like MIT.
Well, could we talk about something else first? I just want to say that what we've gathered here is we don't dare talk about is the reason we have gathered here. When we talk about short-term thinking, what we are here to just talk about is what's going to happen to everything we have now when the excrement hits the air conditioning, to use. Debating this morning said that we are right over the San Andreas Fault, and experts on finance say that it is surely going to crumble. And if we treat each other this badly at a time of prosperity on borrowed of money, how are we going to treat each other when the trouble comes? And I don't say the trouble's coming, the people who spoke this morning said. Now, Weimar was mentioned once. And I think you know what Weimar was the prelude to. And if the excrement is going to hit the air conditioning, the Nazi thing will start here. And that's what we're meeting about, is how the hell are we going to fight that? Is we can't stop this damn fool depression that's going to come along. Now, as you hear the experts talk, it was like the mobilization for World War I. Because once mobilization began, there was no stopping it. There was no speech you could give. There's no speech you can give now to prevent this collapse of our economy, according to the experts. And so that's what we're really meeting about. Now, I'll talk about MIT if you like. I thought that my training is in science. My brother's famous scientist and all that, and I hung out more with scientists than I have with writers. And it seemed to me that they should be guided by a Hippocratic oath. It seemed to me that the president of MIT at graduation should do what is still done in a lot of medical schools, is to take this ancient oath, which has no religious basis at all, merely an ethical basis, as God is not referred to. But all sciences nowadays, all of them, have their origins in the wish to heal, either through appealing for magic or whatever, is to make people better. So I proposed at MIT, I thought this would be very interesting to them, that some of them get together and take a look at the Hippocratic Oath, and to create a modern oath for all scientists to take, regardless of their field. And mostly what the Hippocratic Oath says is that I have these skills to deal in life and death, and I will not help anybody else kill somebody, although I know how to do this. And I will not knowingly make someone sick with poisons and whatever. Well, I thought this was pretty exciting, and they had a student paper there, and I threw out a challenge. Says, why don't you call it the Charles River Oath or the Cambridge Oath, whatever you want to call it, and see whether it doesn't catch on. This was totally uninteresting. It's the least interesting speech I ever delivered, I think. There was absolutely no feedback. And part of the problem was that they only work open to these people, and they paid a hell of a lot of money to get their doctorates or to get their masters or whatever, and they wanted to go to work. And the principal industry in this country, which is probably described, I think, as a white WPA, I don't think the country benefits from it in any other way. But they wanted work. They wanted to have families. They wanted to have kids. They wanted to have a car. They wanted to have a house. And the only way they get it is to go to work for the armaments industry on SDI, incidentally. As you can ask each student, what do you think of SDI? It's a load of crap. It's a load of crap. It's stupid. It's Rube Goldberg. They all said that. They're all going to work on it. But anyway, that was money.